In this video, we're going to answer the question, what is a kilowatt hour? This question relates to a video that Gary and Gordon made recently on this awesome little DIN rail energy monitoring device from Wago. Now, if you're interested in the Wago connections and connectors, then please check out the free training package that we've created to help you out with your CPD. You'll find it by clicking the link in the description below or heading over to the know-how page of eFIXX.co.uk. Okay, so what is a kilowatt hour? It's really important because this unit relates to the way that we get charged for using electricity. Basically, it's a way of measuring energy and specifically electrical energy. Now, if you know a bit about physics, you probably know that the SI unit for measuring energy is the joule. So why don't we use that for measuring electrical energy? Well, first of all, let's figure out how we get to the kilowatt hour as a unit. Breaking it apart, you've got the watt buried in there, which is the measure of power, and you'll know from looking at electrical equipment that this is the starting point for electrical design. Then the kilo, which means thousands of, is on there because that's the order of magnitude that most properties run on. If you've got the kettle on, that's maybe 2 kilowatts. The shower, anything from 7.5 kilowatts to 10.5 kilowatts and so on. If we were to just use watts, it would make all the numbers involved in this process much bigger. Now, in order to measure energy, there has to be a time factor involved, which makes sense because if we leave the kettle boiling for half an hour, it's going to take more electricity to do that than if we turn it on for 5 seconds. And that's where the hour on the end of the kilowatt hour comes in. It's a multiplier for how long the electrical power is used for. So if you turn on a 1 kilowatt load for an hour, that gives you 1 kilowatt hour of energy, and you'll be billed accordingly for that usage. If you use 1 kilowatt for 2 hours, then you've got 2 kilowatt hours. So you just multiply the power used by the time it's used for. So if you use 0.5 kilowatt hour for 4 hours, then multiplying 0.5 by 4 gives you 2 kilowatt hours still. Less power, but used for longer. So why don't we use the joule? Well, the joule is a relatively small amount of energy compared to what we use on a daily basis. 1 joule is actually the same as 1 watt second. So if we were to use joules for the examples given in this video, 2 kilowatt hours would be equal to 7,200,000 joules, which is an inconvenient and scarily big number to have popping up on your energy bill. So there we go. That's the kilowatt hour explained. But as always, we want to hear from you. Do you think local energy metering can reduce bills? Have you installed these energy meters from Wago? Whatever your thoughts or questions, please leave them in the comments section below. And as always, thank you very much for watching.